Acid Rain.
By
Ashley.
Next scene.
And Hudson.
This is Bob the farmer.
And this is his wife. This is their house. And they were very happy.
One day,
his house collapsed.
His wife died. So he thought to himself, very sadly, no hope, no wife,
and no hope.
So he wandered around the streets, wandered around the field,
and took some crops to eat because he was hungry.
He also went fishing for fish to eat.
Slowly,
he ran out of crops and fish to eat. He was starving, and he slowly starved to death. Let's just pause here a moment and look what is happening to Bob the farmer. This is a factory, and it is producing gas. But at the same time, it is also producing harmful chemicals to our environment. One of these is sulfur dioxide. Another one of these is called nitrogen dioxide. Both of these chemicals are not only produced in factories, but also naturally, like in volcanoes. See, when sulfur is released into the air, it chemically combines with oxygen to form sulfur dioxide. When moisture or dust particles are present in the air, sulfur dioxide combines with another oxygen molecule to form sulfur trioxide. Finally, sulfur trioxide dissolves in water to form sulfuric acid. After reacting with each other, these pollutants rise into the air. It becomes acid rain and acid fog and falls on the ground. Let's zoom in a bit and look what is happening to the tree. Acid rain changes the character of the soil. Because of this change, its roots weaken. As a result, plants die. Then the number of trees which absorb carbon dioxide decrease. This further worsens global warming. Meanwhile, in the lakes, the pH in the water is decreased because of acid rain. Fish are dying out. If this happened in Japan, there wouldn't be any more sushi. Sulfuric acid is mostly produced in factories, which produce energy. One way to reduce acid rain is to use alternate energy sources. For example, wind energy, solar power, and hydropower. Another way is to limit your usage of electricity. For example, remember to switch off your light when you leave your house. Also, as a lot of sulfuric acid is produced when burning coal, you can wash the coal to limit your production of sulfuric acid. Most conventional vehicles, such as cars, motorcycles, airplanes, buses, trams, etc., produce large amounts of nitrogen oxides, contributing to acid rain. By taking public transport in preference to cars and taxis, and by walking or cycling to places, these preventable factors can be excluded. Lastly, we were just kidding about Bob's tragedy. Buildings don't collapse after acid rain. Instead, Bob continued to be a farmer and lived happily ever after. Thank you for watching.